Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go in water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee. Rolling thunder, don't hear my cry, don't let Allah.
Tonight, it's the National Football League Super Bowl 55. Brett Maher is set to kick off.
Well, it's been a trying year for everybody, but the tradition continues. Super Bowl 55, away we go from Tampa. And this carries into the end zone. And we will not have a return, so the first drive of the Super Bowl will begin at the 25. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. Throwing now is Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
The man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones, and he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 7 yards there and a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 41. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. He'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jordan Evans. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
And it's third down. Third and long.
Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Play action. It's Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. K.J. Hamler deep for the Broncos. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
Lock and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at the 20. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. Hits his running back, Melvin Gordon. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
Well, after the standard two-week layoff, you always wonder, how's your offense going to respond and come out and play here in the Super Bowl? Well, they got a great answer right there, and almost a sigh of relief on that side of the field, because now they've got to feel like they can use their entire playbook and game plan for this one.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves them with a 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3 at the Packers' 41-yard line.
Shotgun snap to Lock. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of this Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Lock on the give, it's Lindsey. Adrian Amos up to make the tackle.
Adrian, no doubt about it, a really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Ball at the 33, 2nd and 9. To throw it is Lock. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Kevin King with a pick.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got 2 extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. To throw is Rodgers. Oh, he's got a little daylight.
Pass him, and he goes
right side.
Pass him and this.
And he will score. Touchdown, Denver. What a moment for him. A pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember, because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that one pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison in the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended? That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown. 75 yards.
You recall them all. What a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Duke Dawson picks it, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Intercepted. The Broncos take over first and 10 at the 41-yard line.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. After the turnover, here's Locke. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36, and his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Intercepted. The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. And now the throw here is incomplete. And with that, we come to the end of the first quarter of play.
Broncos 7, Packers 7.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. His throw incomplete. Robert Foster, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. He's got Adams on the hookup and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That third down conversion good for 23.
At the 38-yard line.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
First down.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now a first down carry by Jones. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. They'll run it with Jones. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets them up now 1st and goal.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Now Jones, and he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Now whistles here, flag down. I think one of the Packer linemen was moving. Made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on 2nd and goal.
After the penalty, it's Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Being chased out left. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. 4th and goal. So on now for the Packers at their all-time leading scorer, Mason Crosby. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And the 13-year man puts it through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. And that's something of a pick-me-up, and the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put 3 on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all the problems either.
And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's Gordon. 7 yards there and a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and add a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Here's Lindsey. And he's got some space here. There he goes, left side. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Philip Lindsay, 64 yards. And the Broncos push further out in front.
We know it's primarily a passing league now, but anytime a runner breaks one like that, you've got to have a secondary that can find a way to it and find a way to get him on the ground. Absent of that, he's going to find the end zone every time.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a 1st and 10. Flush to his right. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. 2nd down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Rodgers. And he'll look for Adams again, and this time he's got him. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. What a nice little game. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard. To play in this first half. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
At the 40-yard line.
First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get 3 out of this, something about whittling it to a 1-score game at half, it might provide a psychological boost. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Coming up on second and seven. Rodgers now to throw. Flushed out right. He's gonna, the ball comes out. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually. And they'll hold on to the football as well. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble. And now it's third down. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Kareem Jackson. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
You're trailing, you're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter.
Second and six.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Faking the give to Lindsay, here's Locke. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Ready to get their next drive underway. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops, and if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. From the gun, it's Rodgers. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. Rodgers now, after the sack, he'll lead the pack up on third and long. Operating from the gun, Rodgers, and he's taken down, back at his own seven. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. Here's J.K. Scott now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Now a hit and a loose loose football, and the Packers pick it up. The 20, and he brings it back. Can you believe it? An offensive disaster on the final play of the first half.
They just had to hold on to the ball. Obviously, Brandon, they couldn't get it all back with just one score, but that touchdown chips into the lead, and now it makes the comeback a little bit more manageable.
It's up and good, and the lead is down now at 11. It's 21-10. So we've reached halftime here in Super Bowl 55. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, both teams ready after the halftime spectacle, and we are back underway in Super Bowl 55. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Another run by Lindsey. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Philip Lindsey, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. And the lead is up to 18 now.
Good. Makes the score Broncos 28. Packers 10.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing. And try and get back to where you were to start the half.
It's now second and six.
And they'll work from the 29 on second and six. They'll go again to Jones. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Gain of three brings up third and three.
The gun, Rodgers, and that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Well, coming into this one, we expected that this offense would have trouble with this defense, and that's exactly the way that this game has gone. Pressure in his face, coverage downfield has been tight. That led to another incompletion. This defense, they're exactly who we thought they were coming into this one.
Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Rodgers. And he gets it to Funchess complete. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. A
solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Third quarter of action, Super Bowl 55. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Here's a second and 10. Throwing again, Rodgers. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Rodgers' throw is taken in by Jones. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Time and he goes down. Sank back at the 29. Von Miller able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
Second down.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. On play action, Rodgers. Going for it all. And this is going to be intercepted. Monte Nicholson picks it. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
17-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead, right? You take a good look up there and you say, okay, what do we need to do here? Well, you're not in full-out protect mode. You want to make sure you run it, throw it safe, take some time off, and eat it up.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now is Locke. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And that's caught inside the 30.
If you were me,
and all the way home for a Broncos score. KJ Hamler, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Broncos push further out in front.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. And this carries into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
At their own 25-yard line.
Thank you. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And three at the 32-yard line.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Now a look at the backup, Jordan Love. Got a man, it's Tanyan, complete. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
On first and 10, Love. Man over, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 45-yard line. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, Jones. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's the all-pro Von Miller who came in to belt him behind the line. Throwing on second and 14. Rodgers eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Third and 14.
The Packers on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 14. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. And Adams has it, complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Let's pick it up. It's out of time, guys. Out of time. Let's get off the field. Get Mike. Get off the field. Check 26. Check 26.
Get off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot. Couldn't connect.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think part of their plan was to hit him over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line.
Let's go D, tighten up. Let's go D, tighten up. Hey, bro, Mike 20. Hey, me and you all day. I'm coming after you.
Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
And now after the delay of game, they're operating behind the stick, second and 15. Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll go down at the 28. Without the previous penalty, that would have been a first down. Instead, it's just a gain of 10.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
To the air again, Love. And that's complete to Lewis. And they'll get this down to the 10. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Bradley Chubb, his second sack of the night. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. He'll find his tight end here, DeGuara. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A 10-yard completion, but still now facing third and goal. And Super Bowl 55 down to the final 2 minutes. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a third and goal now as they try to punch in a late touchdown. Forced out to his left. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he is not going to be able to get away as they swarm him for a loss shy of the goal line. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Historically, this is such a tough, loud venue, but you can hear a pin drop right now. A lot of fans long gone, not used to seeing a lopsided score like this. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
And Locke throws another one. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. He pitches it, and this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game, and all that pregame wolfing has turned into results.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. And they will take a knee here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Yeah.
And the Lombardi Trophy goes west. And it goes to the Denver Broncos, your Super Bowl champs. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
Just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.